There's no shortage of YouTube videos about how to culture infusoria, and they're very helpful. But I found a frustrating gap in the existing instruction. No one really made clear how long it can take from the time you start the infusoria culture to the time it's ready to use, though eventually I did find some information buried in the comments. When I decided to breed golden white cloud mountain minnows, it soon became obvious I'd have to start culturing infusoria. The newly hatched fry are so unbelievably small. It takes a flashlight to spot them and a magnifying glass to get a good look at them. Though not all breeders agree, in my limited experience, their first food has to be moving to trigger the feeding response and microscopic to fit in their tiny mouths. So before I could get down to the fun part, getting the fish to spawn and hatching some fry, I had to culture a batch of infusoria or risk the fry starving to death within days. It took a lot longer than I expected, and I had no idea how to determine when the culture was ready to use. Hopefully this video will spare others some of that confusion. Starting the culture was easy. I took some green vegetables, frozen broccoli, green beans, snow peas, and lettuce. The type and amounts aren't critical, and boiled them in a cup of water. I let the mixture cool to room temperature, then added it to a clear 2-liter pop bottle. Then I filled the bottle the rest of the way with water from my display aquarium that I'd saved from a water change. That contains the microscopic critters you want to culture. I added a few sprigs of plants I'd pruned from the aquarium because microorganisms congregate on the plants. I also squeezed in a bit of filthy brown water from the filter intake sponge because lots of microscopic cooties live in there. Now I had my nutrient medium, the boiled vegetable water, seeded with microorganisms. I capped it loosely and placed the mixture on a windowsill. Within 2 or 3 days, the water turned cloudy and white, indicating a bacterial bloom from the decaying vegetable matter. That bacteria feeds the cooties you're trying to culture. This cloudy phase continued for some time. Some online experts say it will take only a couple of weeks before the culture matures. My first batch took me 1.5 months to complete the cloudy phase. It will stink. Things will decay. Scum will form. Did I say it will stink? Don't throw the vile, smelly mixture in the toilet believing it's gone bad like I almost did. I went so far as to purchase a microscope I'll barely use just to see if I could spot any live cooties swimming around. At some point, and I must stress the timing can vary a lot, the water started to clear. With good light and a 10 times magnifying lens, I could see critters swimming around in the container. Eventually, as the infusoria population continued to grow, I could clearly see shifting white streamers in the water, clouds of organisms congregating and moving. Here's another thing I found confusing in the other videos. There was lots of footage showing the infusoria under magnification, using a microscope or a macro lens. It was very impressive and interesting, but that's not what you're going to see when you check the progress of your cultures with the naked eye. Here's how my infusoria cultures look at various stages with no magnification. Well, just a tiny bit for one shot. Here's a brand new culture. The plant and vegetable matter is fresh and the water is clear. This is how it looks on day one. No big surprises there. Here's the culture on day two. Notice the cloudy water. The vegetables are floating now, but still intact. At this stage, there's no sign of life, even under bright light and a magnifying glass. This is how the culture looks at 4 weeks. It's still cloudy, but the one on the left is starting to clear. When I checked it under a microscope, there were lots of organisms swimming around, so I started using that bottle to feed my new fry. At 5 weeks, The culture on the left is even more clear, but the one on the right seems unchanged. I checked a sample under the microscope and saw nothing, not a single organism. They were twin cultures in every way. One succeeded and not the other. Go figure. Here's a different culture at less than 4 weeks. With bright light and 10 times magnification, you can just see cooties swimming around near the surface. I was already using this culture, being careful to draw water from the surface because it wasn't fully mature at this point. This bottle is a different culture at day 18, so it's less than 3 weeks old. You can see how that water has already cleared, the plant and vegetable matter has turned to mush, and in bright sunlight you can see streaming clouds of microorganisms even with the naked eye. That's a mature culture and ready to use. Compare two cultures. The one on the left was mature in less than 3 weeks. The other bottle didn't mature until 4 weeks. My first culture took even longer, about 6 weeks. As you can see, the mechanics of culturing Infusoria are simple and straightforward. But the timeline of progress for any given culture can vary quite a bit. Be prepared for that and be patient. I hope my experience with culturing Infusoria is helpful for you. The key for me was to realize the timeline for development is quite flexible, to say the least. Take any predictions based on another person's experience as very approximate. If your culture matures in a couple of weeks, as they say, then hallelujah and good for you. Mine have taken anywhere from 3 to 6 weeks. I also hope the video taken at various stages of development gives you an idea of what to look for and how to know your culture is ready to use. I've actually come to enjoy culturing Infusoria. At first it did seem like a great boring production just to end up with baby fish food. But now I find growing cooties is fun, despite the stench. You already said it stinks. I'll say it again. It stinks. It reeks. It smells rotten, nasty, and vile. Calling it Infusoria makes it sound like a high-class method of brewing tea. It's probably a biohazard in a bottle.